that these things are working, so that way, or if they're not, then I know I can only have one person come in for one-on-one review. So, write a few things down. Okay. So if, and of course you know if you've got makeups because you know you weren't here, you know, if you do have makeups, and I'm talking a half an hour or an hour or 8 hours, it doesn't matter. I need to talk with you this afternoon. We've got to start looking at basically how we can go about and do this. So, and like I said, I'm not going to come hunt you down, you know. I'm not gonna call you on the phone or something like that and say, hey, you were missed a half an hour this day or for whatever reason, you know. I figure you know it, or you know, and I'm gonna let you have the responsibility of getting hold of me. So if it comes down to it and you've got out of a 90 hour certified class, if you have 89.5 hours, that's not roundable. You know, I will round up your test scores, but 89.5 does not round up to 90 hours. It has to be 90 hours, and that's the demand basically of KDHE. Okay, we're on 251 here. Identifying, preventing, you know, weight loss. Probably creativity is probably one of the things that we can do to literally help people find out, you know, what is it the foods that they like? What is it the foods that they don't like? If somebody likes hamburgers, you know, really, is there anything that wrong with them having hamburgers at, and if hamburgers is all they eat, that's what I mean. All they'll eat is hamburgers. You know, is there anything wrong with giving them hamburgers, breakfast, lunch, and dinner? You know, because you can do stuff to hamburgers. You can, like we've talked about already with the protein powders and stuff, how you can really spice them up. You go on to the certified medication aid class. You're going to be surprised of how many people take vitamins and minerals, calcium pills, calcium with D, iron pills, multivitamin pills, potassium. You're going to be shocked about how many of your residents basically are taking, you know, some form of that. And it's a supplement. It's a nutritional supplement simply because they're not eating enough. In the last med class, I know in this one day, between the five students, they passed meds to around 30 people about. And I think afterwards they started counting up. Over half of them were these nutritional supplements. And it's, you know, you walk through a dining hall after a meal and you look at all the food that is left there, you know, there's enough there to feed a lot of people still, you know. Now, why are they not eating all the food? Is it because their taste buds have changed and they don't like the way it tastes? Teeth hurting? Jaws hurting? What is it? Are they anxious? Are they sad? Are they depressed? You know, we have to be the detective, the nurse detective, and try to find out the reasons why. You know, and it could be a simple fix. It may be something that's not so simple, but sometimes it can be a simple fix. So, of course, that's why you're going to be weighing people. That's why you're charting, you know, on your dietary intake sheet, you know, how much. That's why you're going to the charge nurse and reporting, you know, if this person's a 50% or less. And basically, we need to report that before they leave the dining room. Now, yeah, is the charge nurse going to be happy if five or six different CNAs are coming and saying this person, yeah, no. But hey, it's their job, you know, as part of it. So, you know, sorry, but I'm not sorry. You know, it's just like when I call a doctor at 3 o'clock in the morning, you know, I'm not going to start out. When I first started doing it, I have to honestly admit, doctor, I'm sorry, I got to call you. I got this patient of yours in the emergency room. But I stopped that really quick because why do I got to apologize? You know, that's their job. You know, they knew this getting into this, you know. So it's the same thing with the charge nurse. They know to expect people are going to come to them and tell them, you know, all these people that haven't ate enough, because then they have to be reapproached, you know, technically by the charge nurse. What else can we get you? You know, the alternative. Remember, all your meals are going to have alternatives. So if we're having hamburgers today and they hate hamburgers, there's an alternative already ready. It might be fish, it might be a pork chop, I don't know what it'll be, but it'll be something different. The same for the vegetable, the same for the dessert. We're always going to have alternatives that are absolutely ready. So sometimes it's just simply that. You know, there's a bunch of, like here, this gives you a whole bunch of reasons why on 252.1, I mean, why people sometimes won't eat. They just feel cold, their stomach hurts, they have abdominal pain. Constipation will take away somebody's appetite. It kind of backs up and gives them a full feeling. Edema, of course, if the edema has backed up bad enough into their lungs or heart, well, that's going to affect their strength. It's going to make them weak. Inflammation of the mucous membranes or a dry mouth. I mean, you've probably had a canker sore before. I mean, those things really hurt on your lips or on your tongue or inside your mouth. It could be that a dry mouth. You know, I don't know what brittle nails is here. Weak muscles in the face could basically do it. Maybe they feel weak. They feel fainting. The apathy or the withdrawn lack of interest could be an issue. Just there's a whole bunch. Because most of the folks that you're going to be dealing with have one or more chronic illnesses. And probably more like two or three. And the chronic illnesses are like the congestive heart failure, the COPD, the Alzheimer's, the kidneys failing, all of those different chronic illnesses will basically decrease their strength incredibly. So the guidelines, of course, are report observations, report decreases in appetite, report weight loss changes. Virtually, if we weigh anybody like weekly or even monthly, and they have lost 5 pounds or more, the charge nurse has to report that to the doctor and to the family. Now, what usually happens is a lot of places will use that 5 pounds as a parameter. Well, what can happen is the person loses 3 pounds this month, the next month 2 pounds, the next month 4 pounds, the next month 1 pound. And that goes on for 6, 7, 8 months. They've never broke the 5 pound parameter to call, but when you add it all up, they've lost all of a sudden 20 or 30 pounds. And a lot of times, because we see them every day, we don't notice the face getting thinner. We don't notice the skin changing colors. We don't notice this stuff. And then all of a sudden, it's like a slap in the face. Oh my gosh, George has lost 25 pounds this summer, or this fall, or whatever. So we encourage the residents, we check and make sure on our dietary cards that they're receiving the right meal. We respond quickly to their complaints about meal issues. We try to season the food to their preference within their dietary orders, special diets, special adaptive equipment. We got to make sure they have it available. You know, if you ever walk to somebody's, walk the dining room and you look at the tables after they finished eating, and you see a whole bunch of food on the table right behind or right above the dish. Well, you know, most of us, when we eat, a lot of us, like with our spoon, we use our other hand to scoop stuff on or to block it. So we push, like with our bread or our knife, our peas or our mashed potatoes or whatever, we push it onto our fork. Well, if the person, something's wrong with one hand or another, they can't do that, and they just literally chase their food off. They scoot it and they chase it off their plate right onto their table. Gets out of their reach and they can't get it. Well, that's an easy fix. Just get one of those plate guards and clip it onto the back of the plate. So when they do go to push it on, it forms that like a wall, and they can get it right on and eat just fine. If they've got fingers that are just completely, you know, almost destroyed because of rheumatoid arthritis, the crippling arthritis, and they cannot grasp a spoon, well, they've got those bands that can slip around the hand, and we just stick it in, and they can still eat by themselves. So there is a lot of adaptive equipment. The sippy cups work real well. A lot of people with Parkinson's will have the shakes like this, and they can literally empty out their glass of juice or their coffee just by simply shaking so much. Or some people will bump over their glass, and of course it'll spill all over the place, and simply because of embarrassment, they'll up and leave. They're hungry, but they're embarrassed because they spilt it and their other table mates are glaring at them, or maybe even saying something like, "You clumsy," you know, or something like that. So they feel bad and they up and leave. Well, these sippy tippy cups work great, you know. They drop them or they have the shakes, they're not going to spill as much. So there's different things that we can literally find for people. Now, one of the things that works surprising, and this kind of goes against logic to a certain extent, but a person that does have the shakes kind of with their silverware, we will give them what's called weighted silverware, where the silverware handle will have like a lead in it, and it'll be heavier. And the heavier silverware, they won't shake as much. I think it's maybe because the brain is able to feel the heavier spoon or something, so it's like they know they've got it, and because of that, they can grip it better. Again, we put the band across around their hand here if they really have the arthritic fingers and things like that. So there's a bunch of different stuff that we can get, different silverware for the people, you know, to virtually help them. I'm not sure if it's, yeah, here's in this chapter, the nosy cup on page 253. That has the one side kind of swoop cut out of it. So if the person is kind of bending over literally with their head, you know, because you get the cup right about here, it's going to stop. Well, with this section missing, they can take a drink. Some people may not, their arthritis may be getting bad. It's not bad enough for the band, but they simply can't grip something like this. Well, there's these pads that we can, like these foam curler pads that we can slip over the handle of the spoon, so maybe they can grasp a bit like this. So there's a whole bunch of different things to make the dining room experience as pleasurable for the for the residents as we basically can, and to keep them as independent as possible for as long as possible. Because here again, you know, if they're feeding themselves, they're, you know, if I'm feeding them, they're just sitting there exercising their gums, you know, their jaw. But if they're feeding themselves, they're getting fingers, wrist, elbow, shoulders exercise, plus a little bit of a cardiopulmonary workout, so it's helping their heart and basically helping their lungs. So, and if you're at a loss, the person won't eat, what can I get? You know, I've heard that there's equipment out there. Well, what is out there? Ask the charge nurse, ask the therapist. You know, the therapist and the charge nurse should be walking around the dining room. But there's a lot of times where, you know, and not saying this judgmentally, but a lot of times people walk but they don't see, you know? And just because they've walked around the dining room, maybe they haven't caught the fact that somebody's dropping their spoon a lot, or somebody's dropping their cup a lot, you know? Or maybe they just don't see it. They're on this side of the dining room when it happens over here. So don't assume because they're walking around they're catching this stuff. If something's going on and you need somebody to help you figure out how to help your resident more, invite them over. Get them basically involved. Like I said, we want to make the dining room experience as enjoyable as we can for our residents. For all basic purposes, like I said, it seems to be the dining room times is the highlight of so many of the residents' days. So we want to make the experience, you know, as pleasurable as possible. They find security in the routine. They get a chance. You know, we want the food to look good, to look colorful, for the plate to have a nice presentation. We want the residents dressed appropriately. Remember, when they come out of their rooms, they are in a public place. They are in public. So they have to be dressed appropriately. That means we just don't toss on a gown and put a robe around them. You know, we've got to dress them appropriately. Eyeglasses on, hearing aids in, you know, whatever. Oral care done before they come down, that will affect the taste of the food. We talked about how the plaque will sometimes stick in somebody's teeth, and I saw it that time, so you're okay. The plaque will break off and they'll swallow it and they'll taste that with their food and they'll think the food is what tastes so bitter. Yuck. And then again, what they'll do is they'll literally turn around and just head on back.
Are residents allowed to have seconds if there's something that they really like?
You bet.
If they're not on the calorie restrictions?
If there's no issues, right. Yeah. And, you know, I've seen it before where sometimes the nursing home's not cooked enough because it really tasted good and there were a lot that wanted seconds and didn't get it. So, and I know the nursing home has to be concerned about budgets and waste, but you know, the nursing home basically goes through a diet schedule and it kind of cycles, and it kind of varies from home to home, but it may be a 12-week cycle. So week number 3, week number 6, some other week, it's identical. And a lot of times we can pick up really fast on what's the favorite, you know, and kind of take that to heart saying, okay, we better fix more because everybody really likes the macaroni and cheese or something like that.
Macaroni and cheese rolls.
Huh?
I said macaroni and cheese rolls.
Yeah. They like it. So make sure they're dressed. They've got all their equipment on. They're clean. They're ready to go out in public. Seating, of course, means a lot. We basically, because a lot of them do develop friendships. A lot of them do develop relationships, you know, with their table mates. And if there is people that like sitting by other people, then there's the opposite. Some people that don't like sitting by others. And of course, if that is going to make the dining room experience unpleasurable for a lot of them, then maybe we do need to move folks in the dining room. Make sure they're positioned high.
I said, do they really do that? I'm not kind of mean. I'm not kind of high schoolish. Not wanting to sit by somebody?
They do it at my mom's nursing home. They had this one lady like throw this huge fit and like a 2-year-old tantrum.
We'll have to move resident away, like if they're in the same room, to another room. I was sitting at the station one time, and down the hall, what I actually saw was like a shirt come flying out to the hall, and then a pair of shoes coming out, just flying and hitting the hall. And one roommate was evicting the other. It's literally, he was throwing out all his clothes, shoes, everything. And we made it down there before he got to the TV. You know? But yeah. And because you can see how it can happen, you know, for different reasons.
I mean, how do you validate which one gets to stay and which one goes?
Well, okay, most nursing homes are going to judge who was there first, maybe, or, you know, if there is an innocent party, who's that?
Little girl.
Oh. if there is an innocent party, like if there is one that's more aggressive, it might be the aggressor that leaves. You know, it's a bunch of different factors. You know, there is no easy way. Sometimes it's just twin cost, you know, heads or tails, you know. But usually there's one that says, I want to get out of here. And it's a challenge, because then you've got to find somebody to come in there if your nursing home is full.
Personality flashes.
Oh, yeah, yeah, there is.
One is not like the other one snores, you know.
It could be that. A lot of times it's heat and cold. Yeah. One person likes the room hot, one person likes the room cold.
Oh, then I could totally.
So it could be stuff like that. So totally team them before, of course, they go down to the meal, because, you know, you don't want them in the middle of the meal. I got to go to the bathroom, and you're feeding three people. Well, what's going to happen to those three people while you take them to the bathroom? Three people may get hungrier, they may get cold food, you know, so we toilet them before they go down. Make sure they're properly positioned in the chair, not leaning to one side or leaning forward, you know, but sitting up with good body alignment. And in the proper chairs. A lot of your nursing homes are going to say, okay, if they come down in the wheelchair, they transfer out of their wheelchair into a regular chair. Again, to make it more normal. Yeah.
What you just said about feeding three people and someone has to use the bathroom, wouldn't that kind of go down as neglect? Because, I mean, I know you're doing something, but they have to go to the bathroom, and you're trying to promote for them to get up and go to the bathroom, so.
Yeah, so I'm saying, while you go take them to the bathroom, you know, the three people aren't eating that you are feeding.
So, in that situation, no matter what, someone's getting...
Somebody's going to, not get what they want. It's just, you can't be two places at once. So that's why if we take them to the bathroom before we bring them down, hopefully that situation won't arise. Hopefully. But it still does sometimes, but not as much. We got to make sure that we serve the food promptly. We basically, when we serve one table, we want everybody at the table being served, because we don't want George getting his and Bill getting his. But then we start serving over here on this side of the dining room. These two are eating, these two are waiting. We want the whole table basically to get their food consistently at around the